What's not normal is Mayor Cantrell's behavior at a recent parade.
What's up, YouTube? It is your boy once again. And I'm back with another episode of Foolery. Now, someone, when I did the video on the mayors and the commissioners, someone sent me a little note that they said, you need to check out the New Orleans mayor. So I checked her out. She's on there. I was going to get to her anyway. But I went and checked her out, man. And I don't even understand what is going on out here. Why, when these people get in these positions, they just feel we need to just take advantage of the situation and do what we want to do. Now, she's caught up with using the taxpayers' money to travel to different countries and all this stuff, and in a relationship with one of her protective team members. Now, she's married, and this guy's married, so you know it's going to be a scandal, right? So, but you still do it. Because that's the thing we have going on in our community. We have people doing stuff wrong, and we still accept them. Because of what? Probably our skin color. But they be the main ones who dragging us. So let's jump right into it, man. I ain't gonna talk a lot about it. Let's get going, man. Y'all know what to do. Hit that subscribe and hit that notification bell to do what? To get the next video. Now let's jump on this, man. Pink Book Lessons, they pulled this. I let it run. So y'all just listen to it. Let's go.
The mayor of New Orleans has been at the center of a lot of political controversy ever since she was elected as the city's first female mayor. 51-year-old Latoya Cantrell, originally from Los Angeles, has served as mayor since 2018. The city re-elected her after her first term. She is currently serving her second term. Now, when it comes to Mayor Cantrell, like anybody else, I'm pretty fair. But the mayor is back in the news after these new charges from the State Ethics Board. When it first happened, coincidentally, the mayor wasn't able to address it right away. She ran out of the city, well, the country, to a conference in Kenya where she was speaking on climate change and pollution.
Cantrell travels to Nairobi, Kenya today. Her office says she will speak at a United Nations event on Sunday focused on stopping plastic pollution. It says her speaking engagement will be at a session on cities leading the way in reducing the negative impact of plastics. The mayor isn't scheduled to return to New Orleans until next Wednesday.
When I heard the mayor was going over to the continent to talk about pollution, I was just thinking, here she is once again using the city's dime to handle what she calls city business. And this isn't the first time. In 2019, she spent thousands of dollars for her and her handlers to go to Ghana for an Essence event. If you all remember, 2019 was promoted as the Year of Return by Ghana. It was a campaign to encourage Black Americans, FBA, to reconnect with the land. Mayor Cantrell received a lot of backlash again in 2022, just a couple of years later, when she traveled all through Europe, Switzerland, France, Italy, and she said it was all city business.
Y'all remember the mayor from Dalton, Illinois? She also used the taxpayer money to travel and said it was for business. Y'all remember her, this one?
Go to Las Vegas? What is that?
No comment.
You don't know if you were in Las Vegas?
Of course I do.
Were you?
It's not paid by them.
Did you fly first class to Las Vegas?
Any other questions?
Actually, yes. The credit card records do shed some light on tax dollars spent at several restaurants near the Strip, including Cafe Hollywood and Hot and Juicy Crawfish. They show township taxpayers also spent money on the Vegas Strip on everything from steak dinners to hotels and $3,741 just on Henyard's round-trip flight.
I shouldn't have to sit up here.
So my thing is, why are you saying you're traveling for business, but you don't bring back any business? These people are traveling from one city to another city or country, and what does that have to do with your city? See what I'm saying? It ain't making no sense. You're not bringing anything back to better my city, so why are you traveling there?
There's been a lot of complaints and criticism for, you know, is now the right time to leave the country when there's so much going on in the city? What would you say to that?
that there's always the right time to conduct the city's business, and especially expand our cultural footprint that drives the local economy, and making sure that we're making those connections that only embrace our cultural bearers.
Honestly, all that sound like a lot of BS. Let's just be real. Just a lot of BS. Let's just leave it at that.
It's a shame that our mayor, she take lavish vacation on the taxpayer money in foreign country while people are dying in the city of crime.
They want answers now. We need the long-term effort on crime fighting, but we need some proactive things to happen right now.
Latoya not telling the truth.
Okay, so what the people of New Orleans have a problem with Mayor Cantrell is she's going on all these lavish flights and upgrading them to first class. So if you ever flown first class, especially overseas, you know, it costs some money. So she would get the flight, boost it first class, and then not want to pay it back. So see, what you're supposed to do is pay the upgrade back. So you're an employee of the state, you have to pay your upgrade back, and she refused to pay it back.
Mayor Cantrell was accused of taking flights, upgrading them to business or first class, and not paying for it. City policy requires all employees to take the basic fare for the flight. However, they are able to upgrade. If they make that choice to upgrade, though, they must pay for their own upgrade. And if they don't pay it on the spot, the City of New Orleans requires them to reimburse the money within 20 business days. Mayor Cantrell racked up nearly $29,000 in upgrades. She says she wasn't paying anything back. I mean, she doubled down on it with a nasty attitude and disposition, flat out saying, "I'm not paying nothing." And then sometime later, she turned around and humbled herself and said that she was going to pay it back. The police department is horrible, arguably one of the worst in the state, which is why officers are leaving left and right. The city is running amok, basically running itself, a bunch of chaos, and this is all under Mayor Cantrell's watch.
This is what gets me. New Orleans has a lot of issues. You know, like, crime is dirty. People talking about how, you know, just a lot of stuff going on in New Orleans right now. And so you going over to other countries trying to figure out what's going on with their pollution when your city is crazy dirty right now. And the people around, it's like they don't want to live there because of the crime. And it's just bad right now. But you traveling to other countries and trying to figure out what they got going on. Come on now. We know exactly what's going on with all that. You're just taking vacations. Come on.
And if all of this wasn't enough, you have a woman who recently came out saying that her husband cheated on her with Mayor Cantrell. That woman is currently divorcing her husband, and in the divorce filing, she mentioned that her husband admitted to having an affair with Mayor Cantrell. Her husband is a part of the New Orleans PD and on the mayor's executive protection team. In the divorce filing, the wife of Jeffrey Vappi claims her husband has been in an ongoing inappropriate relationship with Mayor Cantrell since May 2021. And side note, I know some of you are like, you've seen him somewhere before. That would be first 48, but yeah. She says her husband admitted to having relations with the mayor and also cited specific dates in August and September 2022 when the affair took place, allegedly. That includes August 2nd, 2022, the day a public security camera in front of a city-owned apartment showed her husband spent 5 hours and 40 minutes of his workday inside of the apartment with the mayor.
See, this is why I don't understand why they're not careful about what they're doing. Like, these mayors getting caught up in all these relationships. They literally set up a camera across the street at another building and just pointed at the door, the apartment that she goes in, and just let it sit there. And they just filmed them all day in and out this building. Like, they gotta be the biggest idiots that's walking the street right now.
Good afternoon, I'm Lauren McCoy.
And I'm Liz Reyes. Well, new at this hour, a new court filing accuses the mayor of New Orleans of having an extramarital affair with a former member of her security team.
And the filing raises more questions about her use of taxpayer time and money following Lee Zurich's series of outside the office investigations. The wife of NOPD officer Jeffrey Vappy filed an amended divorce petition this month, claiming in November of last year, she became aware of an inappropriate relationship between Vappy and who she refers to as Mrs. LC. And a source says that Mrs. LC is New Orleans Mayor Latoya Cantrell. And the filing alleges Officer Vappy has been in an ongoing sexual relationship with Cantrell since May of 2021. And that's the same month Vappy joined her executive protection team.
The filing goes on to claim that Cantrell and Vappy engaged in a sexual relationship and lists specific dates. Most of those dates were detailed in a series of our outside the office reports, which showed Cantrell and Vappy spending long hours during the workday at a city-owned apartment. In the filing, Vappy's wife says her husband confirmed to her that he was involved in an adulterous affair with Mrs. L.C., who again, a source confirms, is Mayor Latoya Cantrell. Vappy was removed from the mayor's security team as our series of investigative reports aired. Now, this new filing raises severe ethical and potentially criminal issues for both Officer Vappy and Mayor Cantrell.
And joining us now with more insight on this is Dillard University political analyst Dr. Robert Collins. Of course, Dr. Collins, thank you so much for joining us. So let's talk about Officer Vappy right now. With this new information that we received today, what could this mean for him as an NOPD officer? Could there be any criminal implications?
Well, of course, they're just allegations at this point. But if the allegations are proven, the issue is going to be that there are NOPD regulations about being supervised by someone and having an inappropriate relationship with your supervisor. So that could potentially be the conflict there, is if he's having an inappropriate relationship with the mayor, and the mayor, of course, was his supervisor at the time, there could be a violation of internal NOPD policy.
And our Fox 8 source is confirming that the LC named in the divorce amendment is Mayor Latoya Cantrell. Are there ethical or potential, once again, the same question based on these claims, potential ethical or criminal implications for her?
Yes, because in addition to the NOPD regulations, there are also civilian regulations within City Hall with city employees that you cannot have an inappropriate relationship with a subordinate. And again, the same rules would apply. If these allegations can be proven, then there could be ethical or even legal conflicts because the mayor was in fact his supervisor.
And one quick note on that, but ethically, who holds her accountable ethically?
Well, ethically, it would have to be if a crime is committed, it would have to be the district attorney. But ethically, it would be up to the city council to investigate this and levy any sanctions. Again, up to criminal sanctions. Criminal sanctions would have to be investigated by the district attorney.
Mayor Cantrell, who is also a married woman, denied the affair in a text message to a local newspaper, calling the allegation sexist BS. Although it's a woman who's calling her out for sleeping with her husband.
Now, this is the crazy thing. If that would have been anyone else, they would be fired, right? Now just imagine all the other police officers and everyone else that got in relationships, they were let go. Nah, not a good buddy. She kept him on. Not only didn't fire him, but put him back on her security team. So now she got a boy toy to go with her, and nobody can say anything. Now, let's check her out again on her behavior at a parade. This a mayor doing this now. Check this out.
Once again, Mayor Cantrell is in the news, this time for her troubling behavior at a Mardi Gras celebration. It's currently Mardi Gras season, so the city is filled with celebrations every day. New Orleans decided to welcome tourists for the 2000 year to participate in these activities. What's not normal is Mayor Cantrell's behavior at a recent parade.
Now you see again, she gave the people the finger. She gave the people the finger in the parade, right? And I think she's a little lit the way she was acting. She had a little cup, probably a little gin and juice in it. But, you know, she fired it off at them like, yeah, you know. But watch out as she come back and now try to explain it on a political way.
So I think if you saw the video, you saw an individual that was given the privilege to ride, not only in a parade, but participate in carnival season, something that this city worked very hard to pull off for all of us to enjoy, you know? And the people who we leaned on to pull it off, they did their job, including me as mayor. So when one of the floats passed by, I was flipped the bird, you know? And I was struggling not to kind of have my my Madea movement and boo back and forth, trying to wait, you know? And I just had to go ahead and just do a little bird flip and say, I love you.
Did this chick just say she did a Madea boo move? You know, I guess from the movie Boo and Madea. Crazy analogy, right? Now you Madea. You do a Madea. You want a big bossy, you know, grandma chick ready to throw down on everybody.
You know, because it was a shot, in my opinion, not at me directly, but the city of New Orleans. And I'm the mayor of this city. I represent the city. And to be so disrespectful to a city that has worked so hard, to get the privilege to have Mardi Gras, you know? So that's what that was all about. And hopefully that will never happen again.
Now, see, this is how these people, they're smart. They know this gang. So they know how to cover stuff up. So she gets her communication director to come out and make this big statement. You know, like in the military, we had this thing, CYA, cover your ass, right? So you always make sure you can cover yourself when you're doing something. You got to have proof, you got emails, paperwork, someone, something that can cover like where you were at, what you're doing, all this other stuff. So she got this guy to come out and give now a more of a detailed message on her behavior.
Said Mardi Gras is a time for satire and jest, all in good fun. The city has been enjoying a safe and healthy carnival and went on to say they will move forward and continue celebrating. Mayor Cantrell has been under a lot of scrutiny, especially in her second term.
You know, this is my thing. I'm just going to cut this off right here. I'm not going to keep going into her bag of tricks. It's enough right there we've seen. You know, just a lot of stuff. And people will revote these people back in office. Just like the pastors. It's almost like a church. Pastor go sleep with everybody, make babies, do all this other crazy stuff. And y'all still will just keep them there and come there every day and praise over them. And people will do this with these mayors. You still got people coming out and saying, oh yeah, they the greatest, they blah, 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 knowing that they are taken from the people. And a lot of times the black and brown are the most to suffer from this stuff. But it seemed like, okay, we put them in the office, like, oh yeah, we got somebody there, they'll finally look after us, whatever. Nope. Because once they get there, it's all about them. Let's just be real. We've been seeing it over and over and over. And yeah, I'm going to get some of these dudes. Don't worry. I know what's saying out there. Yeah, we're talking about the black women. I'm going to get some of these dudes. So don't worry. I'm going to chop their ass up too. Well, guys, that's all I got on this. I'm not fooling with this anymore. Y'all know what to do. Hit that subscribe, like, share, and definitely hit that notification bell to get the what? The next video. And as always and always and always, it is your boy. And I'm up out of here. Stay vibing. Peace.